trusted, and He is capable enough to lead me on.
Amen.
And that's why beautiful book of Jude, the book of Jude, he says the last verse 24th, read the word
Spirit.
In the book of Jude he says to God, verse 25 or 24 onwards, now to Him who is able to keep you,
amen,
from stumbling,
amen,
He is able to keep you from stumbling and to present you faultless before the presence of His glory,
amen,
with exceeding joy.
Amen.
Your God is able to protect you from stumbling and take you to His presence without any abomination. He is able to save you. To God, our Savior, who alone is wise, be glory and,
amen,
majesty, dominion and power, both now and forever.
Amen.
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 So you have a God who is able to protect you from stumbling.
Amen.
Let Him come to push you down, but you have the hands to keep you up. Why are you worried about the hand that pushes you? Why can't you celebrate the hands that lift you up? That's why Jeremiah said in the book of Jeremiah chapter 8 verse 4, read fast, will not anyone who has fallen get up?
You shall say to them, thus says the Lord, when people fall, will they not get up again?
When people fall, will they not get up?
If they go astray,
will they not come back to the Lord? Praise the Lord.
Praise the Lord.
So don't worry about the hands that pushes you. Celebrate the hands who keeps you steady always.
Amen.
Praise the Lord.
Praise the Lord.
Praise the Lord.
Amen.
Celebrate Him. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. So deliverance means it's not that you are recognizing Satan and telling, please go away. Please don't come down to come. Some people are not able to sleep. Why are you not sleeping? Oh, Father, I am not able to sleep whole night because I hear the sound jingu. Okay, you heard jingu. Why did you hear the sound of the Lord? I can do everything through Christ. God has anointed you. Revelation, Romans chapter 16 verse 20. God has anointed you and He is in you. For what? He is come jingu and you have to raise your feet and stop Him. God has anointed you that the enemy that roams around your world will be crushed under your feet.
Amen.
He has hope in you. He has a mission for you. Praise the Lord.
Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
So deliverance means not aware of the evil, but aware of the Lord in you and crush the evil. Destroy darkness with the light. Destroy the evil with the Lord who lives in you. The one who is in you is stronger than anyone in the world. That's why in Psalm 73, David speaks about his experience. Verse 21 to 22, he says, Lord, without being aware of you, I became mad, Lord, when somebody told me, you want to the king's daughter, you want to become son-in-law of the king, it's a big, nice. So what to do? Go and kill the Philistines. I never realized, as a child of God, I am the child of God. I am the child of the King of Kings. When I don't celebrate my identity in the Lord, the identity of the world attracts me and pulls me down.
Praise the Lord.
That's why, what is the kingdom of God? Kingdom of God is not eating and drinking, my dear. It is celebrating, rejoicing in the Holy Spirit. He is with you. You are part of Him. He loves you. He is staying with you. Why can't you stay with Him?
Amen.
He moves with you. Why can't you move with Him? He has you. Why can't you have Him? He carries you. Why can't you carry Him? Praise the Lord.
Praise the Lord.
So in Psalm 73 he says, like a stupid fellow, like a bull I behaved, he says. When I see the problem, When I did not celebrate, who am I to the Lord? I am the child of the King of Kings. When I did not celebrate my identity in the Lord, what the world gave me attracted me. I wanted to become Rajuni Alludu. The king's son-in-law I want to become. And I became like a cow of Bashan and went and killed people like a mad fellow. He lost his identity. God gave me the power to destroy Goliath. Then when he repented, in verse 25 he says, Daddy, now I realize, is there anyone in heaven than you for me? Is there anyone, even if I die, if I am here, I am your child. Even if I die, I am yours, Daddy. Is there anyone in heaven? For me, is there anything in the world so delicious like you, Lord?
Praise the Lord. Thank you.
Verse 25. Psalm 73. Akashamandu, neevu tappa naaku evaru unnaraya? Ee bhulokamulo, neevu tappa ruchi galadi emundayya? Jeevitam anta nenu ninnu koniyadedanayya? Is there anything? Is there anyone in heaven waiting for me than you? That is my home. What the world can they can kill you, your body? What more can they do? Why are you afraid? You are called to celebrate. You are crying. Your call is not crying. Your call is to celebrate.
Amen.
That's why every day, as soon as you get up with a song. Get up with praise. Thank you, Lord. Praise you. The reason I live is to worship you. The reason I live is to worship you. David realized the truth after a long time. So that will be so. We read in 1 Samuel chapter 26. The great king was anointed with the Holy Spirit, called Saul. He filled himself with the flesh because in front of him, my kingdom. I should be the king. I need this property. My children should become king. All if you catch the world and keep the world on your head, the world will pull you down. The book of Wisdom of Solomon, chapter 9, verse 15. The flesh and the world will pull down your soul to the mud. If you feed your heart with his presence, you will live by him. Praise the Lord.
Praise the Lord.
Praise the Lord.
Praise the Lord.
So the evil came into the life of an anointed servant of God, made Saul mad, and he began to want to kill even David, who protected him. So when you are led by the evil, you will do all that nonsense. So deliverance means come to the truth. Jesus said in John 8:32, the truth will set you free.
Amen.
What is the truth? Your call is not to bother, not to be attacked by the enemy, but to be governed by the Lord. Led by the light. Walk with the light and move beyond the darkness. That's why we have Psalm 18, verse 28 says, Lord, you light my lamp. Lord, with your light, my darkness is brightened. Darkness is there, but with your light, it becomes bright. And with your power, I leap over the walls. The enemy puts the walls, yes. Wherever you go, the enemy will put the walls. But what is life of a child? With your power, I jump over the walls. This is my life. Don't walk, jump. Praise the Lord.
Amen.
Praise Celebrate the Lord. Him.
Praise the Lord.
Praise the Lord.
Praise the Lord.
Praise the Lord. One fellow got stomach pain. So he said, Lord Jesus, thank you for the stomach pain. Thank you, thank you. The evil was telling, what this fellow is thanking for the stomach ache. And he was getting upset. And next he said, thank you Lord for all those who are getting stomach pain. Thank you, thank you. The evil spirit said, first we will remove his stomach pain because this fellow is going to pray for everybody's stomach pain. So evil spirit ran away, no stomach pain.
Praise the Lord.
Praise the Lord.
Praise the Lord.
You got to praise him, thank him, worship him, celebrate him. Praise the Lord.
Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
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 So Saul, he was sowing evil, and the world, what the world can give it to him. So he died a miserable death. When you don't hold on to the Lord, the evil will hold you. 1 John chapter 5 verse 18. He who is born of God. Who is a born of God? He who keeps the Lord with him. Yes, he can keep the world. He can keep the problem. He can keep what others have spoken. No. He who is born of God means he renews his mind and he lifts up his mind to the thought of God, to the plan of God, to the presence of God, and walk with his presence. With his presence, he conquers the world. Praise the Lord.
Praise the Lord.
And may God help you to, there will be many trials, many temptations, many evil situations in the world. Till you die, the enemy will be after you. But don't forget, even after your death, your God will be with you.
Amen, amen, amen.
That's why in the book of Romans 8:7-14, he says, if I live, I live for the Lord. If I die, we die for the Lord. Whether we live or die, we belong to the Lord.
Amen, amen.
Celebrate this truth and crush the enemy under your feet.